So it's Ragged Edge Radio broadcast on this Thursday night. So many things around us. I'm reading right here. It's verse 33. They came to the place which is called the Skull. There they crucified him and the criminals, one on the right and one on the left. The place called the Skull. A lot of blood there. Two nights ago, a lot of blood worldwide. The Hands of Glory, the rituals, you know. It's going to happen this weekend, the big month of rituals. I'm not sure you're going to hear it anywhere else. But we want to give you the heads up, along with praying, for astounding power of God. So the Ragged Edge Radio broadcast today, main website is shatterthedarkness.net, shatterthedarkness.net. You're listening to the Ragged Edge Radio broadcast, and this is Russ Dizdar. I'm glad to be with you today and glad to be able to speak about some of these things happening because all around us, God is at work. Listen, let me remind you, every promise, every truth, every scripture, everything we have before us, believe it, step out on it, trust the Lord, and see what he's going to do. The great mission of Jesus. Well, that's the most backed and enhanced and guided and protected work on this planet. So, as I say, nobody knows you better, loves you more, desires you, and all those other truths. Nobody's ever pursued you more. As a believer, nobody has backed you and guiding you and lead you out of defeat, lead you out of carnality, lead you out of boredom. Listen, you serve the Lord. There's not a possibility of boredom anywhere. Joy of the Lord to lead you. Spirit of God inside you to build up the outrage of radical evil all around you. And then the promises. And then you just standing up and saying, God, this radical evil and all that we see and all that is coming, we're going to stand not only against it, but just by the hand of God walk through so much of it. To see the most saved, the most healed, delivered, greatest revivals, 10 million fierce. Now, please, 10 million fierce, please, just go sign up and tell me you're praying. Tell me you're joining us in prayer. We need thousands of you to pour into prayer in all of Northeast Pennsylvania. I mean, just pour and pour and pour in prayers in Erie, Pennsylvania. That whole area, massive satanic ritual abuse, rituals. You've got some of the most wicked and radically wicked and decades of murder and slaughter and control and enslavement. And let me tell you something. May God bring an earthquake. May God bring such power. May God, listen, we've got to pray that God just rips it all open. That would include Boston. That would include Ashtabula, Ohio. That would include Plattsburgh, New York, and all the areas that you know about also. We would also want to pray for justice and God to demonstrate his vindication of Wilfred Wong in Wales. Here's a man of great integrity, Christian background, all that. I mean, just 27 years helping victims, and then he gets set up. Whatever happened, for sure, it was he got on the wrong end of it, a stitch-up, as they call it over there. And we got to put the prayers up. I'm back to respond tonight to in a letter to him. And we're going to have something up next week to where you can help him and help and be involved in the cause there and praying. And we got to just pray for the team members because their safety is needed. A demonstration of God's presence and power is needed. We need all of that there in Wales, the Berwyn prison, and this entire issue with and keep John Wedger. Many of you have seen him as Doug Hagman and I did an interview with John on a day in which either a part of his car was stolen, something happened, and he was willing to do the interview, and he did this great interview. So make sure that you You can go back to the Hagman Report, go backwards and see the, I think it might have been 2 hours, I'm not sure. John Wedger, former major, you know, experienced detective, but again, acknowledging the satanic rituals and the trafficking and the children. And as I will agree with him, it's worse there. I mean, at least we see it, and the darkness than it is here in the United States. But again, one is too many. One individual. Listen, by the way, shatterthedarkness.net or theraggededgeradio.com, you will have at the top there, scroll down a little bit, it'll say the live notes. And if you are new to this, there are live notes to these broadcasts that we're doing right now, and I've never done one this long. We now have over 100 and I forget how many pages right now on this. But it is, it's been pretty massive, well over 120-some pages. And next week, believe it or not, I need to add some more. Because many of you are asking how to get involved, what to do. Now, number one, the first thing to do is, in yielding to Jesus, become as powerful in the Lord as possible. That is number one. I mean, no matter what else occurs, the mission of Jesus, the power he brings, his inseparable living presence, Mark 16:20 will be the experience, and reaching the world for Christ, and all the dynamic discipleship and equipping that turns the new believers into the powerhouses God intended. Now, that's the intent. God intends this, and we want to see that happen everywhere. So I'm going to tell you right now, there's many people eager to jump in, and we want you to jump in, but we want you to know that in ministry, under and in a deep relationship with Jesus, clothed and filled with the power of the Spirit of God, power, that conscious power of the Spirit of God, to turn you into a soul-winning witness, to turn you into a prayer warrior, a dynamic worshiper, someone that can receive the gifts of the Spirit and use them rightfully and beautifully and wonderfully and fruitfully. All of that. To believe, and then grow and grow. And then as you see God work on the field, as you see God save people and heal people and deliver people, and God guides you and leads you, well, it only gets stronger. It only gets deeper. Acts 9:22, you know I mention it all the time. So I want to lead you there. I'm going to keep going. I want everything that God has, all that he is and all that he has on the field of human history right now. 40 million human trafficked and being destroyed by the pimps and the scumbags. Millions and millions slaughtered in the wombs. 100,000 people dying in the drug scourge wars here in the United States alone, let alone around the world, as Satan pushes pharmakia all over the world. And then the deeper, darker, secretive underworld, the big stuff, drop down to the very bottom of Satan's basement, and right there, the gates of Hades, the development of the Antichrist, false prophet, the system, the elitists, and the soldiers, all of that has its backdrop in the most secretive, supernaturally covered, dark blood rituals ever done in history. More's been done in the last number of years, and more's being done than ever. I mean, I could talk about 30 years ago what we saw, what we were engaging. But now it's, you know, even, you know, when I first began to engage this, 1978, 79, we have seen the acceleration in not only the numbers of the victims, SRA, DID, MPD, whatever you want to call the phrases, satanic chosen ones. And again, God gave the insight. That's going to happen. We've been pressing the issue, and some are like, are you going to keep talking on this? Well, we need to. The church should be at the cutting edge, not in La La Land. We should know. We should know what the enemy is, what the enemy's doing, how he works against evangelism, that our struggle, our battle is not against flesh and blood. Come on, we've got to know all of that. Part of that lends towards our victory. We're not ignorant. We're not clueless. Spiritually, when you're clueless, you're going to get beat up. You're going to be pushed aside. You may end up as a spectator, suppressed and silent down there. And that's exactly where God does not want you to be. Satan loves crippled Christians. Satan loves silenced, suppressed spectators who look from afar, if they're looking at all. But God summons you right to the front lines. God summons you and says, here's my power, here's my love, here's the Son of God, Jesus, dwelling in you, with you, in you, by your side, in front of you, behind you. But I mean, you got to, again, Mark 16:20, it'll be a living reality to you, and you'll love it. You'll love the fact that even though sometimes you might get mad at me for pushing hard and saying, let's do this quickly. If you can identify that you are, let me read this. I got this on page. This is on page 120 in the notes, the live notes, 120, quote, if the church and any believer would come out of the dead, dry, cold subnormalism of its current condition, repent, embrace Jesus and all of his word and works, launch out in faith-filled prayers and the full ministry of healing, millions would show up for help and seek the Savior, and the healing flowing from him would come. Now, I'm going to tell you, study again, read again. Let the Spirit of God just pour into you, burn into you. Isaiah 58, healing will quickly appear. The glory of the Lord will be your rear guard. It kind of matches for, you know, that's 2,700 years ago, approximately. But we go to Romans chapter 8, if God is for you, who's going to be against you? So I want you to know, but that comes, it comes from believing God, his word, launching out on it, and then experiencing the truths. As you experience the truth, you know what happens? You just get stronger. It just builds. You just build and build and build. So I think it's really important for all of us as we continue. That's all that happens. You get stronger. There's a first time that you get a dynamic answer to prayer, and you're just like, you know, out of this world, man, where God just answered directly. God designed prayers to get the answers. John 15. He designed that. And he designed that when we start getting those answers and bearing the fruit, he's going to sharpen us and make us even better at it, to do more. Now, that's the great thing. So every single believer that ever wanted to, when you lead your first person to Jesus, when you do it a second time, third time, and you get the Spirit of God saying, go over there to that house, and you get that guidance and direction. When you pray for somebody, and all of a sudden one day you feel power going out, and somebody gets instantaneously healed in Jesus' name, to his glory and to their good. And then the authority, when you rebuke a demon out of a person or out from around you, you feel the oppression, rebuke that presence, command it to go until there's an exchange. And you have the full presence and power of the Spirit of God. You know, we're built for the fullness and the joy of the Lord and the manifest might, strength, and power of the Spirit of God. Ephesians 6:10, going on down from there. So I'm glad to report to you today, no matter what. I'm glad to report to you that this month, September, is my, I believe it's the 46th year that I've been a new birth. Titus chapter 3, that new birth, that regeneration, that renewal, and that relationship when Jesus simply came into my life. Now, I love it. I love telling everybody. I've been talking to some hardcore people lately, and those deeply trained in the underground, deeply trained in Antichrist doctrine, satanic doctrine, rituals, blood rituals, those who had been committed to wanting to be, well, participants and or servants in bringing the great chaos, bringing the Antichrist in. You wouldn't believe some, you know, everything you read in Scripture, it has, you know, the dark side has boots on the ground. They're developing, they're guiding, they're directing. Let me give you one heads up. This is for your prayers. This is for the ears of the Vatican. One wonders about Opus Dei. One wonders about the Legionnaires. Is there a current investigation of certain legionnaires? The Vatican and those who've been downloading the broadcast there in the Cardinal's quarters and other places, the question that I'm going to bring to you today, the question that thousands and thousands, those who are in Italy, those who are in Rome, those who are in all of Europe, those who are in Poland, as you listen today, and you know the massive Catholic influence and backgrounds, all I'm going to tell you this, even the top individuals within Catholicism believe they acknowledge the smoke of Satan, a dark order, the false prophet himself may be down there underground. I'm going to tell you what, right now, you know, massive prayer towards that. You got to remember something. Of all the scripture that gives us the heads up about the encroaching darkness, where to respond? It's not just to know and say, oh, there it goes by, there it goes, there it is. No, it's about our response. We're to accelerate the mission of Jesus. We're to ask God for every single thing he has. Book of Acts, even now as we're talking, even now as you're listening, you and I praying together, God, stretch out your hands to save right now, today, powerfully, to heal with extraordinary miracle, to deliver with extraordinary works, to bring about massive ripping open and exposure, break through the satanic demonic barriers that they've created. Crush those barriers. Bring the whistleblowers out. Deliver them. Bring down the arrogant wicked that we've been praying about in some of the cases. We target Erie today and the Vatican today and Boston today and Ashtabula today. And you can join many other places. Praying for individuals getting saved is vital. But also praying against. Know that your prayers and pastors can lead their churches to become massive powerhouses as you pray for the advance of everything that Jesus is and does and has and that we're supposed to live in. But that prayer also includes praying against. Stop and listen. The example in James chapter 5, that one sheer example when it says about the prayers of a righteous believer, they are powerful, they are effective, and the example of Elijah being given to us. To where he prayed and shut up the heavens. Do you understand the power, the possibilities? In the book of Acts, prayers and praise, God responded with an earthquake and ripped open jail cell doors to get Paul and Silas out. When prayers at Mary's house was going on and Peter was in prison with guards, God sent an actual angel visibly and unlocked everything and got him up and walked through the iron barred gates and got him out so he can continue preaching the gospel, preaching the word. I'm going to tell you right now, among all of the human trafficking workers and helpers and those of you, I love you. Thank God for you. Praise God for you. May God raise up 10,000 more, right? May God raise up 10 million fierce that will do the mission of Jesus, evangelization of the world, in the totality of the power of God, and everywhere we encounter radical evil, we'd be willing to see it brought down. We'd be willing to see God just bring destruction, so as much as possible. We were on the live television the other day. We got invitation, Doug Hagman, the Hagman Report. It's on our main website, shatterthedarkness.net, the one-hour broadcast. You know the difficulty about that broadcast? I've got years and years and years and years with all the victims. I've got many of you, some of which I've read some of your emails today, and some of which I can get to and some of which I know I cannot get to. We're going to be on the field. I'm here home. I'm at the radio broadcast center right now. But we've been in and out and out of state, in state, different places, and in all of this, it involves again that mission. But it involves a kind of targeting to those who have been so brutalized. I want pastors, leaders, and all believers to realize something. We have before us more damaged, broken, enslaved, oppressed people than I've ever seen in the last 40-some years of my ministry. And everything Scripture tells us is that it's going to get bloodier, more decadent, radical evil, more demonization, all of that. How does the church respond? The majority that are still caught in silent spectatorship, which is subnormal, needs to know that Jesus, speaking to the Sardis church, wants, not only wants, but can bring you out of that immediately and accelerate you to become that powerhouse and servant. And so I am asking, you and I are praying together, I am asking that God will just, by the Spirit of God, fall upon you. Power, grace, mercy, might, the joy of the Lord. Dwight L. Moody, the great evangelist of the past, such power of the Spirit of God came on him, he's laying on the floor, and he had to cry out, stop, lest this kills me. God can inundate us with the presence and power of the Spirit of God and turn believers that have borne no fruit, been spectators, been clueless, into the most sharp, frontline, powerful servants, bearing massive fruit, and by God's grace, individually, and you and I together, seeing mountains moved. Mountains. So in America, do we need massive revival from one into the other? I put up an article on the Preempter today. I send out the Preempter. Please sign up for it. Go to shatterthedarkness.net. Go to theraggededgeradio.com, or go to 10millionfierce.com and just sign up for the Preempter. If you don't use Gmail, because they've cut us out, they've dubbed our newsletter, digital newsletter, as dangerous. No, they're dangerous for the communistic antichrist censoring and canceling. Go to Proton Mail. I want to encourage you to go to Proton Mail, but you can go to shatterthedarkness.net today, and you can get to today's. Just scroll down a little bit and get the Preempter. By the way, the Preempter will still have the link to the video with Doug Hagman. Right when you see that, it's going to say this: revival or we die. Why America needs another great awakening. Let me tell you spiritually what I think. There's no way just political, even the political ideology, the political sides have spiritual tentacles in it, presence in it. Globalism does that. Killing babies does that. Perversion and gender confusion does that. Embracing the globalist ideology does that. So here I am as an American telling you in 170 nations around the world, and every single one of you in this United States, how much I am sickened by the president, vice president, Nancy Pelosi, and Schumer and all the rest of the Democrats that have chosen to be the number one promoters of abortion, the slaughter and murder of babies, the number one promoter of gender confusion, gender perversities, and trying to be the thought control police when it comes down to that, and then embracing that Luciferic charged globalism and even an antichrist spirit. And that's not even the beginnings of all of it. I mean, I'm saying spiritually, you don't have to agree. I see that what they're doing from the very beginning, spit in the face of God, open the doors to the devil, and you're going to see broader confusion, greater chaoses, greater eruptions of violence all over the place. You're going to see, you've let the devils in. And so we must pray as powerful prayer warriors, that God leads those leaders, those Democratic leaders, to immediate repentance, or remove them. Now, I believe politically, do everything we can. Get righteous people in every single place possible, because who's in those places matters. And what they do matters here in the United States and in every nation. Ask the Venezuelans. Ask those in Haiti right now. Who's in charge down there? Who's in charge of Haiti after all the decades of hundreds of millions of dollars given in aid? Who's in charge in Haiti? Who's in charge of the Middle East and in other nations? Who's in charge of Afghanistan? So in the world that we're living in, there's you got to realize, please, I beg you in the sight of God for you to become a warrior, to get into the fight, to get into the battle, and to appropriate, experience, and live out all the dynamic victories from the foundation of the victory of the cross and your salvation in Jesus. You know, you move out from that, you're going to see the glory of the Lord in your life. If you remember Jesus saying to the woman concerning the death of Lazarus, he said, "Did I not tell you that if you would believe, you would see the glory of God?" I believe in massive healing. I believe God can raise the dead. I believe God can send angels. I believe God can strike regions and even nations with some of the greatest revivals in human history. I do. I believe in the face of the coming Antichrist and all the radical evil that's out there, and most don't have any clue what's behind. So, just quickly, in this segment that we've been doing here, this part 44. Now we're at part 44. Let me get here real quick. We had A, B, C, E, and D, I believe, did we not? And also, let me see where we're at on this. We are at E, and I believe that's where we stopped. So when you look back at E, 44E, the pain and suffering of satanic rituals, I mentioned back then, I think it was Monday, the hands of glory. And listen, I want you to go back and get that archive and listen to that, because I said Monday night, I've said Monday on that broadcast, and I've said this a year ago, the year before that, that when it comes down to this, if you relook at the Old Testament, you're going to see this, that dark side, demonized nations that opposed Israel, fought about, you know, came after Israel, tried to compromise Israel, they were doing human, baby, sacrifices, cannibalism, bloods. That's how broad and wide it was. And usually out of the high places in the groves or the underground, like Ezekiel 8, but that's where the powers of darkness come through the gateways, portals, or doorways that rituals create, blood rituals create. So I've said for years, and I said last Monday night, that the Hands of Glory ritual going on Monday, you know, was going to happen on Tuesday night, by the way, is going to go on worldwide. Anywhere there is anybody that's still in satanic ritual abuse, and we're talking millions and millions, and 10-year-olds and 25-year-olds and 35-year-olds and 55-year-olds and 70. There are those of the first generation that are not out yet. They can all tell you that. A number of you write me about that. Many of you now are starting to write books, but your freedom from that Antichrist, that whole system is built on a ferocious, frenzied hatred of God, hatred of Christ. They want to do everything to rip everything away from you and from the victims. And that's what it's built on. And so what happened Tuesday night worldwide, as we've said over and over, they're going to do it, you know, all over Rome, all over France, all over, you know, Germany, all over the Scandinavian countries, down in Australia, all over New Zealand, anywhere you find the victims of satanic ritual abuse, even hundreds of them, or thousands, or the millions that have come through the psych wards in the last number of decades, they can all tell you the same thing. They can tell you. Listen, I have seen real pictures. I've seen books of shadow pictures of the blood and guts and babies slaughtered and guts pulled out and killings. And I don't know if you want me to even talk about this. The ones engaging those that are actually doing it or participated or to hear about it or for them to describe the individuals doing it, the people that do it love it. I don't know if you understand this or not. How can we wrap our minds around this, anybody, let alone a believer in Jesus? How can anybody plot and plan to take a 2-week-old baby, a 6-month-old, a 1-year-old, a little girl, a little boy, the brutalization, the sexual, the violent and gross perversion, sexual things that are done, the transmission of demons into them, the cutting of the blood is all about bringing the demons, how these practitioners, they're doing everything they can to get more demons. I want to tell you right now, the numbers of blood rituals are off the charts now. Not once a month, more like 15 times a month. And when Hands of Glory, done in South Africa, South America, Australia, United States, Canada, around the world, where this ritual went on, and we've known this for years, and I've tried to investigate, engage, go after it, take a look at it biblically, what I've written, what others have written. I've looked at all that. But engaging practitioners. We are right now walking the line. The goal is to bring those who are deeply, deeply versed in fallen angel language, the sigils, symbols, signs, a history of bloodletting, blood rituals, demons, powers, their development in becoming satanic super soldiers and astraling and ritual warfare. And well, it was all accelerated last Tuesday night. And around the world, these blood rituals were done, and then the summoning, as I said before, for them to receive more demons, for them to transfer or place into others in the coven demons, for them to summon and then ask the demons to be over them, cloak them, the ritual, the Hands of Glory, lean towards, looking for supernatural power, for invisibility. This is why, overwhelmingly, feds and law enforcement and others can't get in. And you got to understand the physical secrecy. If you can understand mafia, drug lords, gangs, and things like that, and they're strict to physical levels of staying hidden, off the grid per se. Well, you can accelerate that 100 times over, because I think the underworld is more into the physical side of staying secretive. But I'm telling you with every ounce of my being, as much as I can proclaim and believe and tell you of Jesus of Nazareth, his power, his goodness, he's God in human flesh, he's the Savior of the world, I know him, I know his power, I know some of his giftings, I've seen what he, you know, over the years, I've seen in power encounters, demons, by the authority he's given to us freely, to literally just order them and expel them, and all of this to tell you, dark side powers. This is what the problem is of dumbed down Western Christianity. It's like Satan in name only. But what the church does not know and maybe has lost sight of in the last four decades is his development. His real attack on believers, 1 Peter 5:8, it's real. But so is 1 John 2:14. You go read both those, 1 Peter 5:8, 1 John 2:14, and the astounding victory, deliverance, setting free, empowerment over the world, the flesh of the devil, and in ministry, the astounding back. There's nobody else more backed on the planet. There's nothing else on the planet that has the ability to perceive, discern, move forward, engage the gates of Hades. That's not just a symbol. It's all pouring out from hell's, Satan, demons, fallen angels. They are exactly as real as Scripture shows them. The ferocity relentlessness of their sadistic evil is there. Demons, let me tell you something about demons really quick here. Demons, they love and revel in human torture. And if they can get young ones, if they can get their followers, the dupes, to kill them, to torture them, to dismember them, to shred them, to eat their guts, to sexually abuse six-month-olds, and do a lot of things to practice, all to appease the demons, so the demons can come in and revel in all of it. Here's what I've seen. I have seen those who embrace the demons on that level are becoming like them. When I see humans reveling in, holding babies up, talking about the love of it, the power of it, the frenzy of it, the power that comes. Someone told me once, don't you realize when you experience that dark power and that power comes through all that blood and all that ritual, that power is there. And have you ever been raised off the ground by that power? I said, no, not that power. Of course not that power. I would have stood there and rebuked that power and ended it right there. We would have done that. We have authority to do that over all the power of the enemy. I said, you revel? Does anybody, listen, anybody listening, anybody on the dark side, do you really revel in the blood and the pain and the torture and the dismemberment and the desecration and the sexual brutality on two-week-old babies? Really? Then damn you to hell. Just simply that, damn you straight to hell. It's where you belong. Barring your immediate repentance, may God strike you with either grace to lead your repentance right now or do whatever it takes to remove you. Are there any Christians who can pray with power against radical evil? Are there any Christians outraged about abortion, about human trafficking, about ritual, you know, trafficking, the drug lords making billions? They've got warehouses on wooden platforms, just money, all on the backs of pumping what Satan wants out of there. Mexico is barring God shaking the entire nation. The saint of death, 16 million people going to engage demons in rituals to the saint of death. And that's clearly public. There's a lot of public stuff going on. But what I'm talking about here is the example of Kings 3, where the Moabite king slaughtered his own child, a blood sacrifice, to bring powers and let those powers come down, come right on down on the warriors that were fighting Israel. I've said this so many times before. So all I can really try today to do to say in the middle of this series and our boots on the ground. See, I can quote some of the books and materials which I've been doing, and there's a lot of good, great former victims that are now victors. Former survivors that are now standing in the power of God to tell you. And I have always said that them coming out, being saved and healed and delivered and restored and empowered, they're going to be some of the greatest servants on the planet. You go back to Genesis 50. What the devil meant for evil, what they intended to be radical evil, God has intended to use your life. He wants every one of you to come out. He wants every single one of those victims to come out. God wants, who's going to go after those victims? You know, when we think about this, really, the human trafficking, who's going to go after them? Who's going to stand and try to stop the slaughter of babies, which is an abomination in the sight of God, and will bring the judgment of God to any nation and to the politicians that pump it. The stupidity of them, the idiocy, the spiritual arrogance. To do it is to embrace Satan. To do it is to embrace the demons. To do it as a witting or unwitting, either way, There's an old song, Dust in the Wind, but Hell to Pay. The song's not good enough. The clarity for all that. And for those committed super soldiers, for those in the dark side that recon the show to see what we're doing and remote view, and you know, that's all happening. Listening today, even, I have one thing to say. That God does forgive, that God does transform, that the blood of Jesus and what he did at that cross is massively beyond your collective bloodletting. The blood of God in Jesus can liberate you, set you free. Jesus doesn't ask us to blood sacrifice ourselves or anyone else. He didn't need it. We don't need it. He did this for us. God did this for us. And what occurred there at the cross, the physics of God, or the ergase, the work of God in Christ, deliver us from the totality of sin. The power of radical evil sets us free from Satan's ownership, gives us authority and power over him, and plants into us the gift of the coming indestructible immortality and seeing God face to face. It's amazing to me that there are those who will hang on to their demon powers, believe in the rhetoric of the didache daemonoia, the demons' screams and shouts and whistles that tell them they're going to Armageddon, but they've never been told, only to be decimated, only to be blown out of the waters in moments. To the undergrounders that recon the show, have you read Revelation 19, 19, 19, 20, and 21? Have you done that? Or are you just a coward? Unable. It's the very stuff you stand against. It's the very things and individuals. To take a look at that, the very thing that your handlers, your creators, have never wanted you to look at. They don't want you to see. They don't want you to see. They just want you to be the commodities. You're just the doormat. You're just the vessel. You're just the Judas. Then in the end, you're on the rocks. Your guts are everywhere. You are the sacrifice Satan used to stand on, and you are discarded, and you are thrust away, and you are there. That dark side is not going to shed a tear for your being decimated, lost, and sent straight into hell with no way out. Today, the grace of God. Today, the power of God. For everyone listening, you're lost. You don't know the Lord. I don't care if you're an angry atheist. You're lost. You're separated. You need the living Jesus. Nobody loves you more. Nobody has the power to come into you and change and give you. From the scripture says, as Jesus said in John's gospel, you've crossed over. When you come to Jesus, you from death to life. Hellbound? No. Now heavenbound. Do you know him? Can I ask you today, do you know him? Can I ask the wizards and the maguses and the emesicists, the sorcerers and the priests, and to those that are coming, you're halfway out. I want to give to all those SRAs that are halfway out. Philippians 1:6, lock it in. It's true. God's way ahead of all this, and when you look at the ministry of Jesus in Luke 4, I'm telling everybody, all the counselors, all the helpers, I love you, thank God for you. You know, I'm just telling you how vital you are. I know you, we all can get tired at times. May God refresh you. May God strengthen you. May God lift you up. May God bless you with everything you need. May God right now destroy all the satanic assignments and powers and things that have come against you right now. In the name of Jesus, I pray that. We pray that together. We're joining together. We're joining worldwide. We're praying for hundreds of millions to be saved. Please, but what do you believe? Do you believe God can move mountains? Now unto him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly beyond all that we ask or imagine, according to his power, that is at work in us. To his glory, to Jesus' glory. So nothing's impossible with God. You can look at the Goliath darkness around you. And my response is, look at it. It's really there. Look at it mocking and screaming and saying and destroying and all of that. And my mentality is, outrage. In the name of the God of heaven, we're going to come towards you. We're going to do all that we can to bring all those out of the darkness that we can. Those who want to stay in the darkness, die in the darkness, go to hell in the darkness, we're going to do all we can to make that happen maybe sooner. In the name of the God of heaven, today may he rip down, tear down the supernatural structures. May God stretch out his hand to break the supernatural structures over the cities, over the localities, over law enforcement, over military, over politics, over all the systems. May God stretch out his hand to destroy the works of Satan. May God unleash the Spirit of God in the greatest of revivals ever. Great power, great might, great signs and wonders, great healing right now in Jesus' name. And I target for all of us to pray for our own areas. we target Erie, Pennsylvania, in the whole Northeast Ohio area, and Erie, Northeast Ohio, Pennsylvania area, western side of it. For Boston, oh, we're not letting up on Boston, old Magus. You know, we're not going to let up on the ones that think they answer to no one. So, you get a chance today? Read Psalm 10. To all the victims coming out, read Psalm 10. Let God just speak to you. Let God just give that to you. By the way, we are on page 121. If you'll drop down to page 121 of the notes, we talked about why is the big question. Well, because of sin. Somebody asked me the other night, one of the folks in the world of the underground, you know, why does God do this? Why doesn't God do anything? No, humanity did this. Your sins and my sins and humanity's sins does this. We're the ones that opened the door to Satan. We're the ones that gave him the rights. We, by our sin, by our thrusting God out, we did this. So the answer is mankind and Satan. Sin and Satan did this. So if you want to know why it all happened to you, if you want to say in this, see, we're in the battlefield where Satan, he's the ruler of this world. He's the one. That's what it says in 2 Corinthians 4:4. That's what we read about in Ephesians 2. The prince of the power of the air, the spirit that is now at work in the lost, and those who have the sin nature, and those who are on the way to hell itself. And yet Jesus is here to bring the mission, to bring the brilliant, powerful gospel that whosoever hears it, whosoever will believe in him, turn to him, repent, turn around from that sin and Satan, and turn to Jesus, will receive the forgiveness, the freedom, the power. Romans 8, the law, the spirit of life in Jesus will come in, canceling out the law of sin and death and the gift of eternal life. So let me tell you who to blame. Humanity's sin. The people around you, the sinners around you. I don't care if that's family and grandpas and all those that have served Satan and done Satan stuff and done the rituals and done the sex stuff, all of them, they're all guilty. They're all going to pay the price, if not here. Great white throne judgment. No one's getting away. Thank God for the vengeance of God. You ever read the last two Psalms? You might want to read the last two Psalms today. Because I believe in some levels, believers play a part in that. Play a part in that. Point two, the reality of sin, Satan. I already said that. Radical evil. The vast destruction in every way. And again, to Bohemian Grove, doesn't make any difference anywhere around the world, in Russia, and the Satanism there. To any individual that embraces Satan deeper and deeper, like Ramirez in California, like Jeffrey Dahmer, the satanic ritually abused individual that did what he did in a ritualistic way. They didn't tell you that. So you've got to understand that more of this will come, more information from the underworld and many millions that have been there for decades that want out. We must pray the most extraordinary, powerful, miraculous works of Jesus to help rescue them. Angels sent, earthquakes coming, power of God shaking buildings, the power encounters of a sorcerer or a wizard to be struck, the word of God that the days of the perpetrators are numbered. Your time is over. Remember the book of Daniel? Remember the writing on the wall? Remember the words? You see, if nobody does, if no one does a thing, then dark side runs and does unabated. Really, they really do. I mean, silent and spectator Christians aid and abet the devil by their silence. We've got to come to grips to that. In all of this, I mean literally battle, fight for souls, fight for lives, and then targeting some of those that are so completely demonized, ritual blood all over their whole personality, split up, demonized, all that stuff. They're still, as Jesus delivers them and heals them, they're still called on to repent. They must also repent. They must also, you know, and the ones I've seen so many, hundreds I've talked with, hundreds, years and years, young and old. And I've heard from around the world. I heard today. I'm not going to quote or say from who. Point three, the afflicted. That, you know, it's so deep. You really feel you can't speak, but you can. And so I push you towards the Psalms to, you know, anybody who's been, you know, really bloody, you've really been hurt, you've really been damaged all these years. Just, you know, keep going to the Psalms, keep going to the Psalms, keep reading, let God speak to you. He's way ahead. There's more healing, more deliverance, more setting free than you even need. Did you hear me? There's more healing. There's more power to set you free. There's more deliverance. There's more God ability to transform your life, to restore the years, and sometimes instantaneously, to restore all the years they've taken from you. To all the victims, I'm going to tell you again what I've told others face to face. They have, I don't care if they selected and bred and done all that. They don't own you. They want you to think that. They want you to think they're the creators. No, they took from what the material of God. They took from God. They took what God is God's, and they and the sexual event and the moment of consent. That's God give the gift of procreation. All they did was interrupt. All they did was enter in. All they did was try to take it from that point on. All it is Satan trying to mutate humanity and make them servants of their own doom, their own destruction. What I can't stand sometimes is seeing the ones that revel in that. I'm going to tell you right now that there are priests, there are maguses, there are wizards. They gather together. Listen, I know you're not going to like this, but like in the Old Testament, like right now, they love the smell of burnt flesh. They love the cutting. They love the blood. They love the torture. They love the cries. They summon the demons. They enjoy it. It's how sick, perverted, perverse, and radical evil. That's how deep the scum of hell itself has permeated their brains and their thinking. Point four, in the notes, the pain and suffering of the cross. You ever hear this? Who has believed our report? And to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? For he grew up before him as a tender plant and as a root out of the dry ground. He has no form or majesty that we should look upon him, no appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. And we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he has borne our grief, carried our sorrows, yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we were healed. And all of us, like sheep, have gone astray. Each one of us has turned his own way, but the Lord has laid on him, on Jesus of Nazareth, on the Lord Jesus Christ, the iniquity of us all. He, Jesus, was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He was brought as a lamb to the slaughter, to the cross. Israel, this was spoken of 700 years before Messiah would die on the cross willingly. John 10, Jesus said, "No one takes my life away from me. I lay it down of my own authority, and I'll raise it up." You ever read Isaiah 53? You ever read anything about the crucifixion? Luke's Gospel, chapter 23, the crucifixion. As they led him away, they seized Simon of Cyrene, who was coming from the country, and they laid the cross on him to carry it behind Jesus. A large number of people followed him, including women who mourned and lamented him. Jesus turned to them, saying, "Daughters of Jerusalem, weep not for me." Here's Jesus. Jesus has already been beaten. Jesus' back is bloody. Jesus with the crown of thorn, the blood down his face. Jesus mocked. Jesus dragging that cross. He turned to them saying, "Daughters of Jerusalem, weep not for me, but weep for yourselves and your children." Listen, the days are coming when they will say, blessed are the barren who never bore and never nursed. Then they will begin to say to the mountains, fall on us, and the hills cover us. Do you see verse 30? Go to Revelation chapter 6, the pale green horse. Go to the sixth seal. Go read Revelation 6, the sixth seal. Some of the dogs won't do this. Some of the elite, those who think they're the, they won't go there. It's a visual picture of the real Luciferian, all these elitists, what's going to happen to them when they see the day of the Lord. The wrath of the Lamb has come. They will begin to say to them, they're going to go run, they're going to go hide, they're going to go, everything about their lives is going to come out. Have you read this? Two different men who were criminals were also led with him to be killed. They came to the place which is called the Skull, where they crucified him. You ever see that? Verse 35, the people stood by watching, but the rulers with him scoffed, saying, he saved others. Let him save himself. If he is the Christ, the chosen one of God. And the soldiers, stupid soldiers, these are stupid soldiers, they mocked him, coming to him, offering him sour wine, saying, if you're the king of the Jews, save yourself. They put an inscription. You ever see this? You ever see what's going on there? The only one that would ever say these words, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. They don't. They just simply don't know what they're doing. They don't. They don't have clues. It's very important for us to realize today they have no clues. I mean, the arrogant and those that, they're bloodhounds right now. Christians and pastors, they've been doing blood rituals all around you. They've been summoning. They've been sending infiltrators in. They've been doing so many. And someone are going to sit back and say, don't try to scare us. If you're scarable, maybe you don't know the great power of God and the depth of the Word of God, and you've not launched out in the love of God that will cast away all that fear. Believers are to be bold as a lion, not chickens behind a bunch of spectators in a pen. Can't stand that concept. Today, on a live broadcast, on the archives, I believe that God can bring about an initiation of revivals, of saving individuals, of stretching out his hand in great power. Save, heal, deliver, change lives. Turn to Jesus. Repent of all sin. Renounce Satan. Come to Jesus. Call on him. Anywhere in the world, call on Jesus. He'll come into your life and save you. All the believers praying together, joining together. This is the Ragged Edge Radio broadcast. This is Russ Dizdar. Keep us in your prayers. Keep us in support. Thank you a million times over. Love you deeply in Jesus. Good night.